For Management Association of the Philippines President Rogelio Singson, the president's honor was impressive. He says he was greatly encouraged by the plan to continue infrastructure development. But Singson notes Marcos must be careful in deciding which projects to pursue after he vowed to continue and even expand the build program of the Duterte administration.
Why are we still spending for some of these rail projects that have been luckily China backed out of these projects, but why in the world would you need a Subic-Clark rail project? I would rather put all that money into providing water supply to communities that do not have potable water.
Like Singson, Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry President George Barcelon also lauded the president's commitment to infrastructure, but he also called on Marcos to determine which projects our development partners are viable.
The Private Sector Advisory Council lauds the assurance of President Marcos there will be no more lockdowns in the country. It says that is exactly what the private sector and MSMEs need in order to fully recover from the pandemic. The council also vows to help the president in pushing for booster shots so businesses can operate in full capacity. The PSAC, meanwhile, calls for a more simplified system when it comes to virus restrictions. As for the Makati Business Club, it welcomes the Marcos administration's renewed push of attracting foreign investors and forming public-private partnerships.
It's really music to our ears to hear a president say he wants to make the Philippines an investment destination, particularly foreign investment. You know, he mentioned CREATE together with those economic liberalization laws. Developments over the last few years, particularly under the previous administration, made us a laggard in terms of attracting investment. They also made, the previous administration also made policy and actions that would discourage PPPs. We are very excited that PPPs are played a starring role.
Vice President Sara Duterte vows support for the development agenda laid out by President Ferdinand Marcos in his first State of the Nation address. Duterte says her office will work alongside the office of the president to ensure the welfare of Filipino people will come first. She also promises to give her 100% commitment to help the education sector as the education secretary. That includes looking towards implementing the previous administration's basic education development plan to address the impact of the pandemic on the sector. Meanwhile, Tourism Secretary Cristina Frasco lauded President Marcos for making tourism as one of his top priorities. She vows to work with stakeholders to promote what Marcos said was the Filipino brand and transform the sector into an Asian powerhouse.
The speech of the president left me with a lot of optimism, as I know that it will generate much needed hope for the tourism industry, especially our frontliners in the industry that have suffered greatly in the past 2.5 years due to the pandemic and various calamities. Branding is, of course, very important, and the president himself has made it very clear that it's important for us to be able to convey very well the Filipino brand. And that means a re-examination of our identity as a nation to highlight all our best qualities and the best aspects of our nation and to introduce improvements to those that need improving. However, while branding and marketing is indeed one that requires attention, more important is product development, to be able to ensure that we strengthen the tourism industry enough to be resilient and inclusive, especially in times of crisis.
President Marcos's statements of the country's health sector getting praise from health officials, his plan to put specialty hospitals in different regions was particularly well received.
I'd like to thank the president because he has been able to provide us these pronouncements, which were really very much aligned with what the Department of Health was hoping for, especially the CDC, the Virology Institute, and of course the vaccination for the public and bringing the facilities and services closer to the people.
I think his pronouncements were very reassuring in that there really weren't any surprises. And for a country that's gone through a crisis that spanned 2 years, we don't want to be surprised. I think that's the continuity in the plans that had already been laid down from the previous response. Mm-hmm. And moving forward to strengthening what we thought were the effective interventions was very welcome to hear.